हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ मिसेस सोनल पाटिल। वी हैड बिगिन विद द चैप्टर रिप्रोडक्शन इन ऑर्गेनिजम्स। इन आवर फर्स्ट सेशन वी हैव कंप्लीटेड अ सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन। इन द सेकेंड सेशन वी स्टडीड अबाउट वेजिटेटिव रिप्रोडक्शन, वेजिटेटिव प्रोपेग्यूल्स वी हैव स्टडीड। इन टुडेज सेशन we will study sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction involves formation of the male and female gametes either by the same individual or by different individuals. Same individual in the sense, bisexual means what? Here both male and the female reproductive structures are present in the same organism. Unisexual are the organisms in which the reproductive structures are present in the different individuals. So here sexual reproduction involves formation of male and female gametes. These gametes fuse to form the zygote, which develops to form the new organism. So here the gametes are fusing. Male gamete and the female gamete fuses to form a zygote, which later develops into new organism. It is an elaborate, complex and a slow process as compared to asexual reproduction. So in comparison with the asexual reproduction, sexual reproduction is quite complex and it is a slow process. Because of fusion of male and female gametes, sexual reproduction results in offsprings that are not identical to parents or themselves. So here the type of reproduction is biparental, means what? Two parents are involved, and because of which the progeny or the offsprings which are formed have combination of characters, or here you can see genetic recombination is occurring, and because of which the offsprings which are formed, they are not identical to their parents or among themselves. So your clones are not formed. They are different from their parents as compared to the asexual reproduction. A study of diverse organisms like plants, animals or fungi show that though they differ so greatly in external morphology, internal structure and physiology, when it comes to sexual mode of reproduction, they share a similar pattern. Similar pattern in the sense, all the organisms show stages of growth, or they show phases of growth. All organisms have to reach a certain stage of growth and maturity before they reproduce sexually. So before they are reproducing sexually, they have to undergo a certain stage of growth. So here stages of growth are of three types, or they have three phases of growth. First one is juvenile phase, the second is reproductive phase, and the last one is senescent phase. So all the organisms who are sexually reproducing, they will undergo these three phases. First one, juvenile phase. In animals, the period of growth to attain maturity is called juvenile phase. Means what? Here, as I told you, here it is nothing but organisms have to reach a certain stage of growth and maturity in their life before they reproduce sexually. That period of growth is called as juvenile phase. Before attaining maturity, whatever period is there, that is called as juvenile phase, and this juvenile phase in plants is called as vegetative phase. In plants, it is called as vegetative phase. This phase is of variable duration in different organisms. The second phase is reproductive phase. The name itself tells that when the organism start reproducing sexually is called as a reproductive phase. So when it is reproducing sexually, that period or that stage or that phase is called as reproductive phase. The third one is senescent phase. It is the last phase of lifespan. This is characterized by deterioration of metabolic activities of the body that ultimately terminates to death of the plant. So what is happening over here? At this last phase of growth, all the metabolic activities of the body, they will terminate, which results into the death. So these are the three phases or three stages of growth: juvenile, reproductive, and senescent phase. Important question for 3 marks: stages of growth or phases of growth may be asked in the examination. Nextly, we will study about the flowering in plants. Observe a few trees in your area. You will find that the flowering in these plants will not occur at the same season, isn't it? Or you can see that the flower during the same month, you can't see the flower during the same month year after year. So here, why it is? Because the lifespan, depending upon the lifespan, there are 3 types of plants: annuals, biennials, and perennials. Annuals are the plants which are living for only one growing season. They grow for only one growing season. They start flowering at the end of the season. So those plants are called as annuals. So annually they will grow and they will start flowering at the end of the season. Those are called as annuals. Second are the biennials. These start flowering in the second year of growth. That is, they complete their life cycle within 2 years. Within 2 years, these plants will complete their life cycle. Those are called as biennials. In annuals and biennials, the 3 phases of growth are clearly identified. Whereas, if you see in perennials, perennials are the plants that live for a number of years. In these plants, it is very difficult to define the 3 phases of life. Those are called as perennials. So they live for number of years. So there are 3 types: annuals, biennials, and perennials. These are the examples for plants with unusual flowering. A few plants exhibit unusual flowering phenomenon. Some of them, such as bamboo species, flower only once in their lifetime. Only once in their lifetime they will flower, generally after 50 to 100 years. They produce large number of fruits and die. So bamboo species flower only once in their lifespan and they produce large number of fruits and they die. So this is a very important 1 mark question, may be asked in your exams. Name the plant which flowers only once in its lifespan. So that is bamboo species. Many a times the question is asked, so please note it down. The question is very, very important. The second very important question from exam point of view is the name of this particular plant, that is Strobilanthus Kunti Anna. These flower, they flower once in 12 years. They flower once in 12 years. As many as of you would know, this plant flowered during September, October 2006. Its mass flowering transformed large tracts of hilly areas in Kerala, Karnataka and Tamil Nadu into blue stretches and attracted a large number of tourists. So a patch of flowers appear once in 12 years in the hilly areas of Kerala, Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. The name of the plant is Strobilanthus kuntiana. Again, a very important one mark question. You have to note it down. Strobilanthus kuntiana flowers once in 12 years, whereas bamboo species flowers once in its lifespan. Nextly, we'll study about reproductive phases in animals. The reproductive phase is of variable duration in different organisms. There are two types of breeders: seasonal breeders and continuous breeders. Seasonal, the name itself tells that these animals reproduce only during favorable season. So whenever the season is favorable, they will reproduce. Such breeders are called as seasonal breeders. Example, frog, lizard, cow, buffalo, etc. Second category is continuous breeders. These animals actively reproduce throughout their reproductive phase. Okay, so they will continuously reproduce, and because of which they are called as continuous breeders. So very easy definitions. Both are seasonal breeders, reproduce only during favorable season, whereas continuous breeders reproduce throughout their reproductive phase. Example for continuous breeders are rabbit, poultry, birds, mice, etc. Very important question. Again, they will ask you differentiate between seasonal and continuous breeders, or they may ask what are continuous breeders, give example, or what are seasonal breeders, give example. This question may be asked in the exam. So these are the reproductive phases in animals. Depending upon the phases, there are two types of breeders: seasonal breeders and continuous breeders. Among animals, for example, birds, as you can see that they do not lay eggs all throughout the year, or is it seasonal phenomenon? What about other animals like frogs and lizards? You will notice that birds living in nature lay eggs only seasonally. However, birds in captivity can be made to lay eggs throughout the year. In this case, laying eggs is not related to reproduction, but it is commercial exploitation for human welfare. So here you can see that this is a very good example here. Poultry birds, they are laying the eggs in captivity. So the example is given under continuous breeders. Okay, whereas seasonal breeders are nothing but the birds which are naturally laying the eggs. So they show a seasonal phenomena. So they are coming under the category of seasonal breeders. So these are two types of breeders: seasonal breeders and continuous breeders. Reproductive cycles in animals. As I told you that reproduction in animal is seasonal. Birds lay eggs only in specific season. Placental animals exhibit reproductive cycle that leads to change in ovaries and hormone level. Now, what is this reproductive cycle? The cyclic changes that occur in the female mammals is called reproductive cycle. Whatever cyclic changes are taking place in the female mammals is called as a reproductive cycle. There are two types of cycle, reproductive cycles, menstrual cycle and estrous cycle. Menstrual cycle occur in primates, whereas estrous cycle occur in non-primates. In menstrual cycle, shedding of endometrium wall occurs, whereas in estrous cycle, there is no shedding of endometrium. Since in menstrual cycle, endometrium is shedding off, bleeding occurs, whereas in estrous cycle, since there is no shedding of endometrium, bleeding does not occur. Here, endometrium is the inner wall or inner lining of the uterus, which will shed during the menstrual cycle in the primates, whereas it is not occurring in the non-primates. So this is the difference between the menstrual cycle and the estrous cycle. Example for menstrual cycle are monkeys, apes, humans. Estrous cycle is exhibited by cow, sheep, deer, dog, tiger, etc. So this question, many a times it has been asked. They will ask you the difference between menstrual cycle and estrous cycle. Many a times it is asked, so please concentrate your important question from exam point of view. So reproductive cycle are of two types, menstrual cycle and estrous cycle. And this is the difference between the two cycle. We'll stop there, and these are the assignment questions. The first question is, name the plant which produces flowers once in 12 years. The answer is Strobilanthus kuntiana. The second question is, name the reproductive cycle that occurs in non-primates. It is estrous cycle. Then the next question is asked is, differentiate between seasonal breeders and continuous breeders. Now here I have not given the example. You can write the example, you can include the example over here. So differentiate between seasonal and continuous breeder has been asked, third question. And the next question is, they have asked you the difference between the menstrual cycle and the estrous cycle. So these are the differences between the both are been given. So these are the assignment question for this part of the chapter. Please concentrate on these questions. These are the most likely questions asked from this part of the chapter. So we will stop here today, and in the next session we will begin with the events of sexual reproduction and the further part of the chapter. I hope you have understood up till here, and I hope you will complete the assignment. Thank you.